and so, you know, I'm really fortunate to be in that kind of situation. I'm going to talk to Ty every day with that scratch zone and our power play, all right? And, you know, I don't bring a bunch of numbers, but scratch zone for the 4 years that I've been there have been the vast majority of our game, all right? Two tight ends inside, outside zone, okay? Let me start stance, splits, and line, just to show you, I can explain how we line up and how the tight ends up. Center field, you're going to be square. You know, I tell you, if you don't have a place off the backside or right and left, you've got to be square. Your feet have to be square because that's how we're set the three guys on the side. And guards are going to line on 1 foot. Our squares are 1 foot. All right. Never, never wider than 1 foot. You'll see them line them in. It's hard to get the difference if you're far away. All right. We're going to be 1 foot. We will close them down. Certain situations, make sure the guards go around standing stuff, let them inside the protection. Right. 1 foot is your goal. And that goes for everything. You know, we're not going to vary our splits before we play. Right. Our splits are going to remain 1 foot. You know, whether we're running inside zone or going to 2 point stands in front of five step protection, stay at 1 foot. Right. Our line, okay, the guard's going to line his inside toe. Always tell them the night to squish on the center foot. Okay. He's in step. Right. 1 foot, toe to instep to center. Okay. Now, guards, tackles, and tight ends. Okay. Very crucial. In the center too, but without the stagger. The width of their feet. Okay. The width of their feet. I personally like a close, a fairly narrow stance. Okay. And short guys, tall guys, skinny guys, fat guys, we're going to be in the same stance. I'll tell you what I'm saying. A couple years ago, I had a real tall tackle, 6'4", and so he was rail. And because he was so tall, he got this real wide stance. Right? He'd go down, and he never could take a lateral step, right? Without turning his shoulders, without turning his foot. And it was very simple. His feet were so wide that when he took the flat step, you know, he was out of position. Lower body was out of position. So, you know, rat, you're 6'9". I want your feet hang on your arm. Shoulder, but the arm is a little bit, it's about an inch and a half, 2 inches closer to your shoulder. And a lot of guys just say, I didn't get between your shoulders. And I want them a little bit narrower than that so they can take a good first step. Any direction, vertical, 45, or flat, and I have it overextended myself. Okay, our center right now is a bad habit. It's a wide stance like that. He's got to take a flat step to right here and reach and place that shape. And he splits. Okay. Work down and narrow up that stance. Okay? Their staggers are going to be totally instead. Okay? Now, tackles and tight ends, they're aligned. Okay, they're going to want to align inside toe to inside toe to the outside. Right? I know a lot of guys use put your helmet on the rubber belt, align in the center, align on his number, align on his heel. And, you know, to me, you got to, it's kind of hard. I just say put your inside toe on that guy's inside toe. That way we don't get the flying feet. Alright? And young bucks, our freshmen, you know, they align on that outside toe just because it's the closest one to them. Well, now we've got the pressing shape. drove the tank outside on the pit, run to the hash, and let the back kind of, you know, stretch it, and then find it. It's not what we do, okay? Everything we do inside outside zone is based on vertical movement, okay? Vertical movement. It is our biggest priority. And, you know, if you were a fly on the practice field being Coach Flood, you'd probably hit quarter vertical 50 times a day, okay? That step wasn't vertical enough, okay? Your path isn't vertical enough. You're not keeping the down alignment vertical enough. Vertical is the key, guys, all right? You don't want to get washed out. If I washed out, you don't want to get stretched. It's not good, okay? And I know a lot of guys run the outside zone very successful in doing it that way. You know, reaching over the tape, might let that back run. We don't get those kind of backs. You know, we get, you know, a guy that might run 4.8, he's on 4.7. He needs a clean vertical crease that he can get down on him. Not running the sideline if I don't want to go. We're still hacking, so, you know, that's our big thing, is vertical move, okay? All right.
Side A, all the way back. Okay, we've got back on that.
stretch is C, possibly D, back to, you know, it never goes back further than probably the backside edge of the stretch. If you're ready to play side C, you wind up backside C, you will not do a great job of washed out. Okay. All right. Basic rules for stretch and stop. Okay. Alright, if you're covered, let's break it down into cover and uncover. Okay? You gotta have a covered and uncovered situation to run a power cycle. Obviously. You gotta have an uncovered guy to be the helper. Okay? On the stretch, okay, the covered guy, alright, his step is determined by the shape of the defender. And he's gonna give you three shapes. Inside, double one, any position. So that's kind of unusual. Alright, each guard, tackle, tight end, they each can have one, two, three. Now we talk in terms of the old, you know, 4-5, you know, 7-6, 8-9 stuff. But you know, to get it, you know, you gotta one guy, two, you gotta three. Okay? Now their steps are gonna break down like this. Okay? If I've got inside shape, okay, I'm play side, I'm gonna step vertical. Alright, because our aim point is always the play side number. Always a place that I've known. I want to put the T bar or gun. Alright, right smack dab in the 9 or 7 or whatever that place that number is. Okay? So our first step is going to put us in a position with square shoulders and square hips on that place that number. Alright? So if I've got an inside shape, all I got to do is take a vertical step as I'm already around my feet. Okay? If I've got a 2 shape, okay, that place that number is about 6 inches further this way. Alright, so we're going to take a 45. Simple stuff, right? Boom, I'm there, and now my nose is on that place side number. Okay? If I've got a place side shade, place side shades are tricky. Alright? It's hard to get vertical press on a place side shade. I mean, guys got child levers. Alright? Pre-snap. If you got it, if kid does a real good job of getting reach and getting back vertical, which is going to take some hops to do, alright, then you got something. Is to, if you got a 3 over here, you probably got one over there. Alright? That's the beauty of two tight ends. Alright? Make the front, make the box balance. And then you pick the best way to run. Either you do or your quarterback does. It doesn't matter. You know, I think look over and see what you're going to tell them. Alright? But if you do, you do have to run through one tight end situation. You do have a place that shape. You have to run into it. You have to take a flat step. That's what I was alluding to earlier. Put that good narrow stance right there. I'm going to take a flat hook. All right? Why? To get my nose on the T-bar on that place side number. Okay? Now, little coaching point about that. We had a kid a couple years ago. And on his flat step, Charlie, all right? On his flat step, take a great flat step and leave his head backward and start rear to center same. You do that right there. We'll grab that. Alright. That's a good. So now let's make sure we stress it. Alright. You gotta bring your head with your foot. That's what we tell pretty soon. Alright, so if I'm flat here, boom, I'm on my head with it. Okay. Now you notice all three steps, the shoulders stay square. Never want to turn diagonal with our shoulders and our hips. Alright? That's not what we do on our inside, outside zone. It's all vertical. So to get vertical range, you gotta keep your shoulders and your hips square. You gotta call your footwork. It has to go vertical after that first step. Okay? Second step, probably more crucial than the first. The second step, no matter what you're doing, if you're uncovered, you're helping. Covered and you got any of the three shades, your second step has to go vertical. Has to go vertical. Okay? I've heard it a million ways. You know, kick them in the groin, you know, step off the wing leg, whatever. That second step has got to go vertical. Alright? It can't, because if it goes up under yourself in any way, shoulders will turn. Alright? Shoulders will turn, hips will turn. Okay? Alright, so we make shade calls. Alright? The cover guy's got to make shade calls. One, two, three. You got to let the helper know what. pre-hitch rule. Okay, we'll give a shake, okay, first hitch, position step, okay, little heel pose, right? Okay, basic stuff. Second hip move, second step vertical, shooting hands. Third hit, okay, you're chopping. Last hit, boom, is the finish. And that's the hand hits. Okay. All right. I'll hit on speed zone, so on here. Those are adjustments that we make to certain parts. Okay, there's the steps that I alluded to. Okay, the stretch. Now, here's where it changes the zone. And back up there at the top, okay, it mentioned that on stretch we want to take the edge, and on zone we want to increase that gap. So to do that, we do what's called PIG, PIG. And that just stands for protect inside gap. And that's going to be your play side cover line, okay, on zone, inside zone play. Instead of stepping with the place of the foot like stretch, all right, but we're kind of working to that C gap, all right, since we're working place side A and back, we want to take a little jab inside right there, okay? The change the helper at all, okay? The helper on both places is always flat. Why? Because he's got to get his hips next to the covering gap, all right, to work our power zone, okay? So that guy is just going to take a jab. Whatever the shade is dictates how big that jab needs to be. Okay, if it's an outside shade, it's just a short one. Because if I take a big one, there's the turn hips and the turn shoulders. Okay, so I'm just going to jab and then second step vertical. There we go. Alright, second step, clean down two shade, boom, maybe a little bit bigger. Second step vertical, there we go. Alright, if I've got a one, we're running zone, which is the scenario you want. Okay, I'm going to pick that thing, boom. Pretty good. Now my buddy's flat step, we got 1 foot splits, it takes an 8-inch step. That leaves us, what, 3 inches for our hips and shoulder pads to be rubbing right there. It works out perfect. My foot's going to be a little bit in front of his, but it works. You know, it works. I mean, the feet aren't always going to be here. You know, it'd be there, it still works. I mean, they still get off together and you get that shuffle on that time. Okay? So that's the pig on its own. That's the only difference in the two. Still trades, news versus being front, you know, powers are the same, the rules are the same, the only thing changes, they like cover line. Back side, just like stretch. Hey, everybody cover guys, just like stretch.
Okay. Hey, Coach, we're doing that, we keep both those guys in vertical. Now the viewers, one of them chip off, they pray vertical.
Hey, great question, thank you. Hey, there we go, just going to go, okay? Here's what we tell them, okay? We're going to get vertical press level 1-2, level 2, okay? Hopefully, the linebackers are slow flowing or freezing a little bit, okay? Because the plays are so, the schemes are so similar, they don't know if it's the stretch or the zone, okay? So they're not going to haul ass thing to stretch, and then we pop the zone on back door, all right? And vice versa. So they're there for us. They're there for us. Okay, here's when you come off. When you reach the linebacker with the down line in tow, that's when you can come off. The only time that we call it premature separation, all right, or another term. The only time that you would abort the power zone before you get to that level 2, all right, is if you're getting a quick back over, all right, or underneath, run through by the linebacker. I always call it that. They quick trigger. They saw us come together. They dived on the ground and back to quick trigger underneath. Okay? That's when you've got to come on. If he's fast straight over the top, let it go. Let it go. Back's the adjuster. Okay, we're not going to turn it into a speed zone or a, you know, a stretch scheme, right, to go get a running linebacker. Yeah. Let it go. The back sees it. Bam. Okay, so to answer your question, we're taking the level 1 guy to level 2. And the way that we introduce power zones to our young bucks and the way that we start out with our old kids, we put linebackers out there. Alright, we say take this guy, park him 10 yards back there, and finish it. That's it, we put linebackers back there. But while they're working their power zones, their eyes are on the second level for the quick trigger. Alright. Questions on that? We need to draw some X's and O's here. you got everybody reaching place on shades, and you got three guys wobbling up vertical. You got four man blocks and three man blocks on linebackers. Look at that. It's a purpose. Okay? Somehow, all right? Somehow find a way to run the play this direction. Okay? So, we're running the play this way. Okay? Covered, uncovered, one on one, left foot vertical. Okay? Right foot vertical, flat. Second step vertical. At that point, your hips are together. We call it siamese. Alright, that's probably the second most popular word here. Alright? Siamese. The Trey Williams siamese duck. Dude, you gotta get a better siamese. Hey, it's bad siamese. Alright? When we're talking about your hips weren't together, you're split. The defender's gonna split you like a draw log. Alright? Square, vertical, hips together, boom. Together, boom. Bulldoze rash, alright? Okay? So they're gonna take this thing for straight ass vertical. We don't like it carrying in, we don't like it carrying out. Take it vertical and keep it vertical. Force this guy to stay vertical. Okay? Pinch the linebacker play will go. Super fast out, don't let it go. Don't chase it. Stay on the tray, back cuts in, alright? Makes the wheel wrong. He's off. He's gone. Okay? Hey, ace. Guard the center power zone is ace. Okay? Same thing. Left foot vertical, right foot vertical, flat vertical, side mixed up, straight back. Okay? Straight back. Alright? Same thing. This is the deuce. We guard the time to work together. It's the deuce power zone. Vertical, vertical, flat vertical, straight back. Okay? Exact code. Okay? Now, here's your ace. If this thing waterfalls, that tray waterfalls, that ace back is just going to continue that path and just take that thing right off that tray. Okay? Something happens, the tray doesn't get its job done, hey, boom. He bends and he starts looking. Okay, for that first vertical seam that he sees. Alright? Vertical seam. Bam. He hits that. The ace gets washed out. Bam. He hits that. Okay, he's north and south. Okay. Alright. Split front. Split front. Okay, same principles apply. Now, I know we split a lot of people play the mirror shapes. Hey, 2-7, 2-7, 27, 27. You know, we see that, you know, we see a lot of 3-1. Shaded options. If you're getting a 3-1, again, find a way to check the play 2-1. Okay? If you're getting a 9-1, not the split, but I mean, you're getting a 9-1 and you're chasing inside, that makes sense. But you don't check it to the tightest that's been. Alright? So, you know, just find a way to get your power zone. That's what we do on Sunday. How are we going to get the most power zone? This way, turn it out. Find a way to get that done. Okay? I split for the center twos. I guess that's the old way that we play twos and stack those back. Okay? We're going to protect the edge. In a split, you're going to have edge players. Okay? If you have a step, he's going to have an edge player. Okay? Block him with the wide out, block him with the U back. Okay? Don't block him with the interior gaps. Alright? So we'll, you know, let's say that we're in 22. Alright? We'll take that U back and lock that edge guard. Okay? Alright. Trey. Okay, right from vertical, left, flat, vertical, boom. They're working with this one. Okay? You always work the first back to the inside the down line and that's your power zone. Okay, basically rule of thumb on that. Alright? And he acts a little bit further in than an even front when he's in the bubble. Alright? So this is where you get the most quick trigger back door out of this guy. Because there's that extra, a yard and a half that peaks inside. Okay? So on a split front, that tackle really has to train his eyes on the tackle to make sure he's not quick trigger. Because the ace is not responsible for the. Alright, that ace is working back in the band right there. Okay, so the tray's vertical for that. Okay? Brought our ace right here. This could be a 45 because it's been a 2 shade, which is a head up shade. Alright? Then he goes left foot vertical, flat vertical, he's on his left foot. There we're for bending. Okay? Now, counter. Backside, same thing. We're gonna get a deuce, okay, five vertical, flat vertical. They're looking for a full bend player. And split front, guys, we're gonna do two things backside. Okay, he's gonna blitz off the edge, he's gonna fold in and cut back. Alright? So these guys have to train their eyes all the way back here on this edge player. Alright, and split front. Then you gotta work your guard backside cut off. Okay? Let's hide it. Alright? Let's split front. Okay, alright, and your odd front. Becoming very popular. Alright, these days with the spread offense, they play the 3-2, alright? And teams at base out of it, you know, when they see two tight ends, they just stick those two edge guys and bring it down into nines, and it's the old open front, you know, the old defense. Okay? Alright, now whatever, you know, shapes, how they're configured, okay? Those two gap player, alright? Cover, no powers on the tie end, on your own butt. But it is cover pulls the block for steps. Okay? So the tie end knows, alright? Either knows because the tackle made a shake call, which tells him that he's not on cover, he just made a shake call. He looks over, so he's tackle to cover, or you can have your guy make trade his loose calls. Alright? You can't get a trade call, he knows he's not powers on. So he's saying, so he's going to go flat, vertical, and aim point is right there, T-bar at that nine right there. Okay? And again, we expect him to get vertical. Alright? And I know it's hard, but crap. I mean, you know, if you work, any, you know, if you work anything enough, hard enough for the man to get done right, it can be done. And I can get a kid with a 3 shape, take a good flat step and get vertical, and take a guy with a play side shape, a play side flow, and flow on that, he gets vertical. Not all the time, but, you know, and that's the beauty of where we're at. We get a lot of tight end type kids. You know, we get a lot of those, you know, 6'1", 6'2", you know, 200, 250, you know, the little kids that do stuff like that. You know, we're not playing glorified wide receiver. We got guys that get there and block. We got our deuce right here. Right now, again, we're working with a play side shade. This score is thinking I'm probably not going to get much. He's still going to step as if he is, though. Alright, he's not just going to haul ass to the linebacker. Okay? He's still going to go flat vertical, check that B gap out, that C gap out, or B gap. Alright? He's still going to go flat vertical. If the anchor, if that, the end five technique, if he slants or unders, alright, boom, now we're working our powers on him. Alright? If he stays on my second step, if I don't feel anything on my second step, my vertical step, then I've got to waddle right down on the linebacker. And sit. You know, they want to do that because they're so ingrained to get to people wanting to get moving. They step, they don't feel anything, they step, and they want to linger. You know, they want where he at, where's he at, where's he at, and always cover, where's he at. And then back is, you know, gone. He's there, he's there. All right, they got to go. They got to boom, boom, it's been there, and I'm gone right now. Again, vertical, we waddle up the linebackers. We do our linebacker drill on boards, you know, on standard boards everybody's got. Make them waddle vertical. We have to take that flat and cover step, waddle vertical, and then we flow backwards to them. Okay? So don't want them fishtail, you know, all the way to the linebacker. Okay? So we'll work that deuce. So we'll go flat, vertical, we'll go flat, vertical. Alright? Waddle up, volley, unless the counters, and then we got our deuce right there. Okay, same thing, we're next. Okay? Boom, 45, vertical, flat, vertical, working to the wheel. Drop that beat down, slide up to the D line, and now they're going to that beat. gotta give up a single now and again. Playing a 6-1 double solid or a 6-2, you gotta get some singles. We work a lot of single block stuff too, along with our power stuff. All right. You'll find that, you know, as you really come off and you're not gonna keep blocked, and then they go crap. You know, I just solid up and take away that stuff. So you gotta work your singles too. All right, you work your ace right here. You gotta be careful on this ace. It's really easy to get backdoor on that. Alright? So they really gotta train their eyes back there. We talked about a quick four right there. That guy triggered, he's gotta come off, he's gotta stay on. Alright, but get your front press. If he goes over the top, take that nose, park the right, and then his flat. Alright? If anything, if you're getting vertical movement, make this guy bubble. Make that guy bubble. That's a beautiful thing. Love when that happens. Okay? Because that's not, he's not taking a quick right now path to the back. He's having the bubble and coming redirecting back downhill. Hey, that makes back cold. He's going by that pole. Okay? And then work the cutoffs back here. Okay? Now, if you can't be running into the, you know, this direction, alright? Then you go single, loose, single on the nose, backside loose, and you cut off back there. Okay? Any cover, run cover situation. Okay? Alright, so.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Can I ask a question?
Stretch. If you've got an extra fender, cut edges, okay? Very one back play, all right? Same thing, Trey. This tight end now, though, is going to take that pick step. A short little inside jab, right? Take that inside gap. Take that inside gap. That's where the play's going, in there, okay? So he's going to take a short jab, second step, or that never changes. Cover to cover stretch song, second step, always work, okay? Uncover guy doesn't change, flat vertical, okay? Now the Siamese stuff in trouble, okay? Same thing, jab, dig, second step vertical, flat vertical, they go. Nothing changes backside, okay? What's he going to do? He's going to pick away from the play, if that makes sense, all right? So he's going to step vertical, vertical, flat vertical, boom, that's the code, okay? So that's the only difference in zone. And that's good for those linebackers, because they see exact same blocking scheme with both plays. Alright? It's good for, you know, mess up the keys and stuff. Okay? One thing really get key off is the A's back to pass. Okay, the downhill step to inside tight end's butt, avoid the flat shelter from the zone. And okay? We used to run the zone steps like the stretch, we found that it was carrying him out to the floor. And basically the two plays have become one. So to keep him square to play side A, and we start to shove him, okay, down him. Okay. All right, now, split defense, okay? Split defense. Run it zone. When I first got there, remember we blocked zone exactly like stretch, okay? We trade that up, okay, to that one, we get a set up to that one, we do some folding players, same thing. Well, the problem was, the good teams that were trained well and then seen this, maybe, you know, in the desert or something, they knew that H backs had, right? Those backers wouldn't flow to the power spot like they would on stretch. So it was a lot of quick trigger and nice and forward quick. So something that you can do, we don't do a lot of this, okay, is you can push those power zones. Right? You can push those power zones. What I mean by that, instead of say this tray, right, working this D, first back there inside the down line of the power zone, and they can push it to that monster. You can work, why? Because he's going to fold in there. If he comes there, we ain't worried about it. We're going to take the edge on his own. Okay? We're going to push this A to this D right here. Alright? Why? Because he's going to be real tight and be there and there. Alright? Again, stay vertical, and now just take this right to that peak right there. Same thing with your deuce. Okay, push that deuce to the vanity. Forget this backside pull. Alright? But, you know, there's some adjustments on that slide, that first slide. Zone push and stuff like that. Where would we use a zone? Where would we use the zone? Again, they're taking away the power zone. This team, this team, blah, 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 blah. They give you inside shades. Alright? And they got guys out here or whatever. Alright? And they're giving you inside shades. That should be a single, that should be a single, that should be an ace. Okay? So the 1 foot splits. But this guy right here in that B gap, okay, and they like to pinch those things in to knock off that guard. Somebody was real good at that this past year, trying to knock off that guard. Right? And then they push straight that damage. So what we'll do is we'll just pull zone that whole side. Alright? Zone him up with a flat step, zone him with a flat step, zone him with a flat, zone him with a flat, and pick the band up all the way out here to the tie. Okay? Still expecting to get work left that flat step. Don't want to get washed out. You don't want to turn into a mushy side of our play. Okay, take your flat step, whatever's in that gap, second step vertical, let's go. Okay? But that would be somewhere where we can use a zone concept. Okay? Push team versus stack backers. Okay? Any questions on that? Stretch and zone. Okay. call play. Our call play is quite similar to a lot of people's power play. You know, we're going to block down, we're going to kick out with the fullback, and we're going to pull that back side guard. Okay? We're going to do that there right there and see that on our work. All right? So we're in our 22 set, the tight end two back, we're in our 21, and we're in 22. All right? Now, what you can do, okay? What you can do is with your tight end, don't just always have him rush down the C gap. I'll give you an example why you would want this option that I want to talk about. Let's say you got a 7 right here, and you're running a power up here. Okay, you're gonna block down ABC, and you're gonna pick out the A, you're gonna pull that right here. If you don't have a tight end that's just a freaking man shot, and that anchor is, and that defensive end is, that's a one-on-one washdown block with that tight end, okay? And that can be tough to do. All right, that can be tough to do. Much as I like to say, screw it, just get it done. There's an easy way to skip the gap usually. So if you've got a set, you've probably got an extra finish, more likely, okay? Release that tight end here at the edge of the finish. The guy that normally about the fullback together, release him there, and now kick the 7. Okay? And then you're still going to fire a combo here, like that, and pull that back side guard. Alright? Let me drop the play real quick. I want to talk about fire combo. Just close the power zone. Okay? So let's say we got a 9, a 3, a 1, and a 7. Okay? You can front. We're running power this direction. Okay? Tight end's got a 3. Watch down the CDM. Okay, it's got a 3 watch on the C gap. That's the only way to do it with 3. 1, more releasing, watch down, or whatever. Okay? He's just going to run back with an in and up step. Okay? I'll show you what anybody knows what we're going to say. Alright? We're going to power combo. We're uncovered, we're covered. Okay? So we're going to power combo. A power combo differs from a power zone in that it's diagonal. Press as opposed to vertical press. Alright? We use our carbos, our counters, and our powers. Okay? So we're going to go diagonal with this thing. Now, to do that, you've got to orient your hips and your shoulders diagonal. Very simple thing to tell the kids. Keep your shoulders in the direction that you want to block that defender. So, if I want to take the defender vertical, keep everything vertical. If I've got to take that defender that way, all right, then orient your hips and your shoulders that way. So that's our in and up step. Okay? Inside foot upfield is what in and up stands for. Okay? Now the angle will vary depending on the shape that you have. Okay? If I've got a 3 shape, that's an easy one. 3 shape, I want to power over here on the right side. I'm going to vertical up that in and up step a little bit. I'm still going to orient my hips and my shoulders diagonal right there. You don't really talk in terms of level 2 men, you've got to get through that. We squirt packs. A gap path, B gap pass, C gap path. We squirt packs. Whatever crosses that path gets picked up in our combo. Alright? But you got a guy pulling, you got a guard that's going to clean it up. Alright? So I'm going to go in and up, boom. I'm going to do the same thing, coach. Inside hand here, outside hand here, get the inside hand free. And now I'm oriented diagonal, I'm going to take that thing here. The uncovered guy, he's got a flat out his in and up step a little bit because that guy's all the way down in here. So he's going to flatten it out a little bit, all right? Head across to stop penetration because the covered guy's got no leverage on that guy. Hey, I got a place side 3 where to go over here. I got no way to watch this guy down. The best I can do is post him up, which is that's why we vertical up that in and up step. Post the inside up. This guy is going to take him that way, all right? He's responsible to post, alright? Get the guys rock back. This guy's the one responsible for the diagonal move. So I'm going to step flathead across to stop penetration. Inside hand to the back to the play side number. Outside hand to the play side shoulder back. Okay? And I tell them, they don't want to do that. They want to keep it free. I'm like, hey, it's okay to turn your shoulders that way. Boom, boom. And torque that sucker that direction. Okay? Now you got a guy posting, you got a guy prograding that place side shoulder. And there's your power combo. Alright? So that's what this tackle is for. head guys are off quick. We will get that moving, all right? So we'll tell them just to work that path. Walk back to your center, flat step that across, make sure you don't penetrate with some hands. If you're a reader, okay, at high school, you step, he wants to go play side right there, okay? Second step up, feel the boom, catch that thing on the flat back, okay? Okay, this guard, okay, he's going to step, he's going to pull, and he's going to hug that power combo tight. He wants to rub shoulder pads with that power combo. On pull, don't turn sideways, guard, it's not counter. Kicking out, it's power. Keep your shoulders square where you're going, all right? Little drop, little crossover, shoulders are square, here comes the power combo. Feel it, feel it, feel it, feel it, and fit. On whatever it is. Fit on whatever's there. All right? Okay, backside. If the tap is uncovered, even front, eagle look. Guards cover tackle time. The center of this tackle, remember we've got 1 foot splits. We're going to get them hip to hip right here. Call that a tangle. Alright, we're going to get them hip to hip and they're going to work up to this wheel right there. That's that though. Alright? But with 1 foot splits, you can do it. Alright? You can have your center and your tackle guard in between, get hip to hip, and get vertical press. Okay? Probably surprising, when we started doing that, we used to just have this guy's whole knee gap get up right there, and we'd give a wide three on that pulling guard to center out a hard time, guy in the butt side, get to it. Hey, Ty, you know what down there, since you can't get a piece of that three, sure enough, make his arm get up, make him get up right there. Okay. Now, get that seven. Here's the one deal with that seven. Exception to what I was talking about a little ago. About the path you use power combo. What else say you got to do from seven? Okay, you're running power. Okay, right here. Knee outside releases, I said just roll that. Knee outside releases, you're picking that seven. Now the use power combo really needs to get to that man. Okay? When before I had that extra guy that tied in, didn't really have to get there. Work your path, if he shows himself taking the confident to go. Alright, but you got to tie in and pull outside of it. If the tie in makes a one call and you're using this release scheme on your power, that tackle here's 1-1-1, he knows it's not coming down in the seek out with him. Alright? So on his deuce power combo, we need you to get to that band. We need you to get to that band. Okay? Because if not, you're going to get outdone. Okay, because you're only pulling that one. So here's your deuce power combo. You got to get here. Okay, there's your tandem, the wheel. Okay, here's your pull. That one right there. Okay? Because if they don't, if he doesn't understand that the tie is not there, they just work this thing down. That guy takes a big bow. Now you got 2 feet going. All right, let's see.
Okay. You change the path something off then?
No. Coach, we don't. We just tell. For now, it's just suffice to say, hey, tackle, if you get a three pull out of your tight end, just take that deuce part and just road grade that sub. Just road grade it. Okay? Now, the bandit wants to put your underneath, that's the exception. Just road grade it because you've got a tight end covered in the seat you got right here with the bandit. If you get a one call, get to the bandit. One of you two, get to the bandit. Don't change your path, don't change anything, get your bag moving, but now we need to get to the bag. So it's just still, we're just making aware of the shape of all the tie and what they need to get done. Okay. Alright, let me show you tire front. You're down. Okay, you're down. Trade power combo. bones, and to the deep. All right, this is good verse in this front. You're gonna see it, you're gonna see that song. Strong through whatever, right? We say it. Ace and our combo, back side.
All right, to that back number 17 right there. All right. both of them stuff. Okay, imagine if that thing was vertical, look at this guy right in the chin. He takes you back to that linebacker. Okay? 4 foot. First hand. Okay, so he's single. Alright? Okay, working the ace, you got zero nose, backside guards are covered, working the ace power zone, backside backer, cut off on the back. Okay, see, if we get a pretty good trade, pretty good press, good Siamese, not a real good step out of the pack, but you see, they got their hips together, they got their shoulders together right there, they just engulf that in, and they did pretty decent press right there. And again, with that backer so far aside, I don't know where to go. You get a lot of quick trigger, but that tackle has to quick come off just like it does right there. Okay? But anyway, the ace back's angle from the inside of the butt cheek and the tie in, they hit good press, just continues on. Alright? And then that folder folds back to him. He just loves it and he just follows that track. If the tray's getting stomach, go to 5 minutes for a crease.
Every single one of our interior linemen,
guys know we got this back in Sacramento City. This might be the one I'm talking about. Okay, again, a variation from out front. Okay, play B gaps, D gaps, got locked up in the E gaps, and stack that behind the nose right there. You know, we just work the rules, cover to uncover, work the powers on the first back there inside. Work the powers on the first back there inside, cut up. Get some good press right here, park it right there, guys, punch it up. Or make it close that, look out, open it up right here. Good thing about, we heard a guy talk the other day, looks the board up on the snake and said, the only reason we spread it out is because I don't know how to get it from back out of the box. I don't know how to block them all up, so we just spread them out and tease them. Good thing about people with low blocks, right? Once you break level one, sometimes level two, anybody left, you know, when they're all spread out from one side to the other, the counter's all over the place. You know, you get them in here back tight, you take care of level one, boom, you pop the grease. It's going to wing our backs and use one of those. We got to move all the guys. Okay, quarterback takes the edge, just bring that thread, you have some pullback. Shoulder to the hips. draft. Trey's the most important about us on the stretch. Ace is the most important on the field. Which is where the ball is headed.
Pretty decent news right here. This side means, I have to look turn. It's not going to be what I was talking about earlier. They both climb up and they leave this one. Somebody needs to stay on that guy. Left him out, left the corner out, to the tight end on the safety. There's no getting a lot of twists, and you're afraid that you're not going to get guard coverage, it's so strong. Instead, the ass can be vertical, and you twist and just pass off and go to the guard. Move and press right there, ground up, move and flip drive, and flat guard.
Thank you.
about the tight end? The CF back. Hey, see, that's what I was talking about with Bill on your car company stuff, you know, stuff. See, that stuff, I don't know, you can cross, guys, inside shit, you got to find out your stuff, but it was the, you bad, you can cross over. You didn't cross over, alright? It's on the backside of that guy's penetrating all day. It's not, not good. Lock your car, that's what we're trying to do.